Hello, I'm Chris Williams from Read Comics, They're Bad For You, the name of my YouTube channel. Or if you're watching this on BitChute, the name of my BitChute channel is Comic Freak. Today we're going to be reading some articles about how, well, J.J. Abrams and his cast have lost the script to The Rise of Skywalker and how it was nearly sold on eBay, of all things. Well, I suppose with their inept attitudes and how they constantly spewage into politics, this isn't surprising. But let's read this article to see what's going on. The script for Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker ended up for sale online months before the film's release, according to director J.J. Abrams. During an appearance on Good Morning America on Monday, Abrams revealed the script inadvertently fell into the wrong hands. One of our actors left the script under their bed, and it was found by someone who was cleaning their place, and it was given to someone else who went to sell it on eBay, he explains. Refusing to name names, Abrams keeps mum on who the culprit is, though many predict it was likely one of the film's leading actors, as they would have access to a full script. I'm not going to say which one, though I want to, he says, to laughter from the audience. Are you sure they're laughing with you, JJ, and not at you because you're a moronic idiot? Because I am. I laugh at you every day, JJ Abrams, and I love doing it. But seriously, these morons lost their script, and it was nearly sold on eBay. A Disney employee reportedly saw the eBay listing and bought it so the company got it back before it was sold, Abrams says, presumably foiling any plans the dark side had. I really don't like that joke, JJ. You're not funny. Except when you are being an inept idiot, then you are funny. John Boyega, Daisy Ridley, Oscar Isaac, and Adam Driver all star in lead roles in the film, while supporting players including Kerry Russell only have minimal script access to their scenes. Russell previously told Entertainment Weekly she was only allowed to read the full script in a guarded room and was able to read the preceding scene to hers. The security is insane, Abrams adds. The company was really nervous about anything getting out, and so they had only a handful of scripts printed on crazy, uncopyable paper. During his chat with GMA, Abrams announced the film was completed yesterday, ahead of its December 20th release. You mean you only finished the film only a month away from its release, you pathetic idiot? Here's the other article we're going to be reading today, how J.J. confirms the Skywalker script leaks. J.J. Abrams confirms that a real Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker script has leaked due to a theft from an actor associated with the movie. Abrams revealed on Good Morning America on Monday that an unnamed actor had the Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker script under the bed of their hotel room, where an employee of the hotel found it, stole it, and put it up on eBay. One of our actors, I won't say which one, I want to, but I won't, left it under their bed and it was found by someone who was cleaning their place, Abrams said, and it was given to someone else who then went to sell it on eBay. This article does cover the stuff we already talked about earlier, but this does have some more information we will find interesting. But right now, let's continue to insult J.J. Abrams and his cast for losing the script that Disney painstakingly tried to keep secret. Because Disney, despite everything they are just a bunch of paranoid douchebags, but they're inept paranoid douchebags and they can't do anything right. That's why they keep buying IPs, because they can't make anything new anymore, and they're worried that they're going to lose everything they have because they can't do anything right. Abrams also noted that somebody who works for Disney managed to buy the Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker script off of eBay and got it back before it sold. Abrams didn't mention any of the reported leaks from the film that have made their way online. And this is mainly why I wanted to put this article on this video, because we're going to talk about those leaks. Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker script leaks may be online. We can speculate that whoever stole the script also may have made a copy or took pictures of the script. And I would say that's a good assumption to be made because of all the leaks we're getting lately and all of the bad press Disney is now taking because of those leaks. Leaks like the fact there's going to be a secret Jedi created by George Lucas himself, not to mention the fact that Rey is most likely going to take the name of Skywalker now as a title, which I really hate. Now we'll learn more about it as we get more into this article. Various leaks have made their way online on 4chan and from various YouTubers. It's possible some of these leaks may not be legit, or another possibility is that Disney put out their own fake leaks in order to combat the real leaks to essentially throw people off, so that nobody knows just what is legit or not. A recent Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker leak offered the complete ending, which could be from the leaked script that Abrams mentioned, or again, it could be all made up. It could be a lot of these leaks are a preemptive move by Disney in order to save The Rise of Skywalker from being, well, spoiled before anyone can see it. But I doubt that. Not all of them. I'd say this script has been leaked online, and the ending of The Rise of Skywalker is now known pretty much by anyone. And no matter any way they can, no matter what Disney does, they will not be able to save this movie, mainly because people are not even having that much hype for it because of The Last Jedi. So I don't see any way that Disney can get people to see this movie now with a bunch of fake leaks. What kind of sucks is that Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker opens first in Japan a full week before the rest of the world, so all the spoilers will be online. No idea why Disney is going that route, as movies such as Infinity War and Avengers Endgame saw their worldwide releases all at the same time for the most part. So if you want to avoid spoilers, stay off of the internet, at least a week prior to the release of Rise of Skywalker on December 20th. I can recall that when The Force Awakens and was released, trolls were spoiler bombing social media and various websites with the news that Han Solo had died. Trolls, you call people who were heartbroken to see their hero killed by his own son? Trolls, and were going on the internet and crying about it? Because they couldn't believe Disney killed off such a popular character and just gave us this lame one named Kylo Ren? But I guess that's to be expected, because it's either racists or trolls nowadays. From a tweet from Good Morning America, Star Wars launched 42 years ago, and 24 days from now, the final chapter will be revealed in theaters. We are thrilled to have director J.J. Abrams with us this morning, and he's sharing an exclusive clip from The Rise of Skywalker as he explains why the Rise of Skywalker script was stolen from under the bed of one of his actors, and he tries to make excuses and still says that The Rise of Skywalker will be a good movie, even though I've seen him look rather despondent with him knowing that this movie will bomb. No doubt Disney is releasing fake leaks to combat any of the real leaks there are online right now. But, as I said, Disney isn't going to save this movie. Besides the fact that the script has been leaked, the fact that fan enthusiasm for this movie is so low, and the fact that, well, SJWs themselves don't really go out to see movies. They only like to go online and say that they're all totally down with diversity and with women, but no, they don't go actually see these movies because they don't have the money. Does it really matter if the script is leaked online? As I understand it, 75% of this movie is already being reworked on, so when was the script leaked? Was it leaked earlier in the year? I'm pretty sure it was. So we have no idea that what's going to happen in the movie will still happen what it was in the script, but I have no doubt it will still be a messed up piece of movie making, because remember, Rian Johnson, under the leadership of Kathleen Kennedy, killed off Snoke just so they can make Rey into a super woman and make her need no man and be the most awesomest ever. And because of that, Disney and Lucasfilm had to go and get Palpatine to be the main villain in their Disney trilogy, because they did not have a strong foundation to build their movie trilogy on, and because of that, all they could give us was a Mary Sue who could do everything and basically no one could relate to. And they both destroyed and then killed off the heroes of the original trilogy, and now they're going to finish the job off with The Rise of Skywalker, so say goodbye to the last of the old school characters from Star Wars in it. If you like this video, subscribe. Make sure you're still subscribed, because YouTube is going around unsubscribing people, so make sure you're still subscribed. If you're watching my videos but you have not subscribed, please subscribe to me. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, Read Comics, They're Bad For You. And remember, there is misspelled T-H-E-R-E because it makes it easier to find. Then go over to BitChute and subscribe to my BitChute channel, Comic Freak. Hit that bell for notifications, hit that like button, and leave some comments down below. And if you could you please share this video? Share it on Twitter and share it on Facebook. Share it anywhere you think it would do the most good, because YouTube isn't going around promoting their own YouTube creators anymore. And it would really help me if you could please share this video. Now listen closely. Keep checking back in future videos for more information on my own upcoming independent comic book, Scum Dogs. I'm Chris Williams, and I'll be back again tomorrow with another video or review.